Hello again, everyone. I'm Tom McDonald on Sports Extra tonight, Sunday, April the 8th. Tiger Woods has all four of golf's major championships. You don't want to call it a Grand Slam? Doesn't bother the Tiger. The Yankees banged out 20 hits at the stadium and routed the Blue Jays. The Mets had some words with the Montreal Expos, but it was the Expos that swept the Mets back to New York. Rough game for the Knicks down in Miami. Kurt Thomas mixed it up. And we'll go one-on-one with one of the guys who's the most improved player in basketball today, the Knicks' Marcus Camby. Sports Extra is on deck.
Allie McBeal's in trouble again.
I'm suing you for defamation, you total...
Allie McBeal.
Tomorrow at 9 p.m. on Fox 5.
Grandma gets stung.
I was just a cheap, tawdry sex toy.
The Nanny, Monday at 7 p.m. on Fox 5.
The Toyota 4Runner is famous for taking you places other four-wheelers can't. And right now, Toyota is rolling back prices on every new 4Runner. As much as $1,500 on selected models. Plus, with some newly standard features, the 4Runner SR5 has never been a better value. So see your Toyota dealer now and get your next adventure rolling.
Going to be our greatest mission.
It's the episode that started it all. See the aliens' first discovery.
They seem to have greater power when they collide.
And their first meatloaf.
I have dead cow on my hands.
Laugh out loud, buddy.
The first, Third Rock.
You're not from around here, are you?
Third Rock, Monday at 6 p.m. on Fox 5.
We do not help kids one by one here. Too many of them, too few of us.
The trials.
The monster we battle every day is disrespect.
The triumph.
Women screamed as if I were a beetle.
Scream because it's scary when you sing.
The tragedy.
Everything that happens around here isn't my fault.
The teachers.
I'm proud of what I see him becoming. You must be some teacher.
Thank you.
Boston Public.
Tomorrow at 8 p.m. on Fox 5.
It's Homer the Heavyweight.
I'm purposely gaining 61 pounds to get on disability.
The Simpsons, Monday at 6:30 p.m. on Fox 5.
Tiger Woods is now the measuring stick for greatness in golf. He is the gold standard. Tiger won the Masters today, outplaying David Duval, Phil Mickelson down the stretch. So at this point in time, Tiger is the reigning champion of all four majors. The U.S. Open, British Open, PGA Championship, and the Masters. No one has ever done that before. David Duval created a three-way tie for the lead on the seventh hole when he rolled in this long birdie putt. It was Tiger, Duval, and Phil Mickelson all at 12 under. But Mickelson didn't stay tied for long. On the sixth hole, he missed a short putt and fell out of the lead for good. Now we go to the eighth. Tiger takes the lead all by himself with the birdie putt. At this point, he's 14 shots under par. David Duval matched that with this long putt, and they're both even atop the leaderboard, both at 14 under. Now we go to the 11th. Tiger, a great second shot to the green, almost went in the hole.
Was that any good?
Tiger rolled in the birdie putt, and once again, had the lead all to himself. David Duval answered that on 15. If this goes down, it's an eagle, and he has the lead all by himself. Just missed, got the birdie. Once again, tied with the Tiger. On the 15th, it appeared that Tiger would run away from the field. A great approach shot to the green on the par 5 hole. But not only did he miss the eagle, he also missed the birdie putt as it lipped the cup. On the 18th, Duval again, one shot behind. This is his stroke to the green. Comes up, tries to tie the Tiger, but Duval misses.
Oh, what an opportunity.
So when Tiger walked up the 18th fairway, he was alone atop the leaderboard. On the 18th, all Tiger had to do was get down in two, and the tournament was his. But Tiger never settles for anything but the dramatic.
As grand as it gets.
When it was over, Tiger Woods, the only man in golf to win four straight major championships, had a big hug for his mom and for his dad. In the sport of golf, Tiger Woods, simply the best.
When I made the putt, yeah, it was great. It went in. And then I kind of walked over there, and then I started thinking I just won the Masters. It was just it was a weird feeling, I tell you that. And then I started losing it a little bit, and I tried to pull it together because I had to shake Phil's hand and come off the green, and I was able to do it somehow.
And you think Tiger's victory was a surprise? Check this out. It was on my desk tonight. He just wins, and it's there already with the four championships. Tiger Woods, simply the best, as we said before. Coming up next, the Mets and the Yankees. The best thing I can say about the Mets game today is tomorrow's opening day at Shea. As for the Yanks, they won big, so they were in a good mood in the clubhouse when it was over.
You're going to be playing a lot more this year as things stand right now. You up for that challenge?
I'm going to be playing a lot more. Yeah, sure. I mean, as a DH, I mean, it's hard for me to get hurt walking through the clubhouse, going up to hit. So most of my injuries have come as a result of playing in the outfield.
Love the answer. Time now to put the keys in the Jaguar. Crank up the engine and find out who the Jaguar Player of the Week is. Robin Ventura is the winner because of the game he had on opening day against the Atlanta Braves. In the eighth inning, he took John Rocker over the wall for a two-run home run. In extra inning, the game-winning hit by Robin Ventura. Another two-run homer as the Mets won the opener. That's why Robin Ventura is the Jaguar Player of the Week.
Hey, where's that turkey pot pie?
You're ready to buy a home, we'll help you get a loan. At Washington Mutual, we write our own approval rules. That's the power of yes.
Fest has arrived. Our annual celebration of everything lobster. For a limited time, a variety of lobster creations at a price that's truly appetizing. So if you're a lobster lover, don't hide. Go overboard for Lobster Fest at Red Lobster.
Yankees had a laugher today at cold and rainy Yankee Stadium. They staked Roger Clemens to a six-run lead in the first inning. Went on from there to hammer the Blue Jays 16-5. The Yanks pounded Toronto pitching for 20 hits.
It was good to see everybody get hits. Sometimes when you have a game like this, there's always one guy who doesn't get a hit. And I think we had everyone getting hits. Please tell me everybody in the lineup got a hit.
Yes, they did.
Okay, good.
Derek Jeter got the first of the Yankees' 20 hits, and he legged it out into a double.
How'd the leg feel after that?
Well, it felt fine. You know, I felt all right yesterday as well, but that's how baseball goes. Some days you get hits, some days you don't. I'm still not where I want to be, but I think I'm swinging the bat all right.
Jorge Posada certainly swinging the bat all right. His towering home run into the upper deck was a grand slam and made it 6-0 New York Yankees.
Well, that's my first one, and, you know, I'm going to remember that for a long time, so good pitch to hit.
Yankees had a lot of good pitches to hit today. Chuck Knobloch had three. Derek Jeter also with three, before Joe Torre took him out in the middle of the game.
Joe gave you that blow just to give the leg a rest, or what was the reason for that?
I'm old, man. He lets the old guys come out and blow out games.
When you win 16-5, you laugh afterwards. Roger Clemens went 6 2/3 in the cold and pitched well enough to get the victory.
You know, we did what we wanted to do. Toronto came in here and was knocking us around a little bit. And, you know, I definitely wanted to go out and set a tone early.
Tony Bautista, who leans out over the plate, got the message, hit on the hand, able to stay in the game, back out on the mound. Rocket and the Yankees talked about how tough it was to grip the ball today.
You know, he said he couldn't grip the ball and say Splitty wasn't where he needed because he, you know, the ball was slippery out of his hand. So, but he, you know, got tough on me and, you know, got out there and threw it like he wanted to throw.
You know, give the hitters all the credit. They came in right in that first inning and start hitting the ball all over the park and big grand slam. I mean, everybody today did it as far as the hitters are concerned.
Festive mood during the route. So when the rookie Scott Seabold came up for the first time in the big leagues, he got a standing O. Didn't get a hit, but the Yanks sure got a lot and runs too.
Today was a very good day. We needed that kind of breakout day, I think. I don't know, if I'm not mistaken, that might be more runs than we scored the previous five games, so it was a fun day for us.
There appears to be some bad blood between the Mets' Turk Wendell, Montreal's Vladimir Guerrero. Yesterday, Guerrero swung at a 3-0 pitch with his team way out in front. Today, Wendell showed his displeasure by throwing at Guerrero. Maybe Turk was just frustrated, though, by Montreal, taking three straight from the Mets. Ball bounced Montreal's way. Al Leiter's pitch broke Jose Vedro's bat. Bat and ball went towards third. Robin Ventura couldn't make the play. That allowed the go-ahead run to score. Mets could be without two of their outfielders when they play their home opener tomorrow. Benny Agbayani hit on the wrist by a pitch. Don't know what his status is going to be. And the guy in right field, Timo Perez, re-aggravated a leg injury. Mets had their chances today but couldn't deliver. Edgardo Alfonso, with only two hits on the season, popped it up with the bases loaded, and that ended the Mets' threat. Mike Piazza also came up with the bag's juice. He popped up. The end result, the Mets lost to the Expos 5-2. Montreal is 5-1 on the season. The Mets are 2-4. The Knicks in Miami reheated their rivalry today. We've got the interviews and the highlights up next. And a little later in the show, we'll go one-on-one with the most improved Knick, Marcus Camby. Loves to talk basketball, but he sure doesn't want to discuss that confrontation with Danny Ferry.
Just an unfortunate situation that happened 3 months ago, which I prefer to leave in the past. So, you know, something that I've learned and grown from. And, you know, there's people who really know me, you know, it's definitely out of my character. But, you know, something I have to learn from. I learned from it, and I'm definitely moved past it.
We'll hear more from Marcus later. This week's stop on the NASCAR circuit down in Virginia, and that's where we go for the Subway NASCAR report. Dale Jarrett, driving car number 88, took the lead for the first time with five laps to go and took the checkered flag at the Virginia 500. He's won three races this year, two of them back-to-back. That's the Subway NASCAR report.
Monday at 6 a.m. on First Edition, cutting costs and cutting corners. Who's best for the job on home repairs? The fix-it man or the licensed contractor? Details Monday at 6 a.m. on First Edition. Jim?
Then, face your fears.
Oh, I hate crowds.
Manage your fear.
Get tips on Good Day Monday.
Starting at 6 a.m.
on Fox 5.
When you live out as far as he did, chances are you're not near one of our stores. Unless, of course, you're near a computer. He knew the jacket he wanted and the color. And then got shoes, a tie, and a belt. Because after 40 years of marriage, well, he knew it'd be hard to surprise her. But at least, he thought, it'd be worth a try.
Now as close as your computer, the Men's Warehouse.
You're gonna like the way you look. I guarantee it.
In 1951, Toyota introduced the Land Cruiser. Today, we have the most extensive lineup of sport utility vehicles in America. For families and individuals. Mountaintops, as well as soccer fields. And, like the original, all of them are designed to get you there and back.
No. I said sell it. Call them up and ask them to give it all back.
In this point-and-click, risk-it-all-on-a-dot-com world,
what's wrong with this phone?
It's nice to know at least one thing doesn't go up and down. Wendy's Super Value Menu.
Hi. Junior bacon cheeseburger, side salad, and a drink.
Because everything is always 99 cents.
Wait a minute. It's on us.
It's there for you.
Now biggie size any Wendy's combo. You could win your choice of three exciting vacations at Universal Orlando Resort.
Is it too late to choose something else?
It's one thing to watch movies. Whoa. At Universal Studios Florida, you can feel them come alive.
Where are we? Look what's over there.
And now, enjoy no line, no wait ride access at Universal Studios.
I drive naked.
Elaine's getting down and dirty.
Naked, naked, naked.
Max Seinfeld.
Tonight at 11 on Fox 5.
This is going to be our greatest mission.
It's the episode that started it all. See the aliens' first discovery.
They seem to have greater power when they collide.